The Legend of Guadalupe. The story of Guadalupe begins in December 1531 in Tenochtitlan, Mexico City, when the Virgin Mary appeared four times to the Indian peasant Juan Diego. He was on his way to Mass when a beautiful woman surrounded by a body halo appeared to him with the music of songbirds in the background. As the birds became quiet, Mary announced, "I am the entirely and ever virgin San Mary," assuring Juan Diego that she was his compassionate mother, and that she had come out of her willingness to love and protect all folk of every kind. She requested that he build a temple in her honor at the place where she stood, the Tepeyac Hill, on the eastern edge of Mexico City. Juan Diego went directly to the Bishop of Mexico, Zumarraga, to relate this wondrous event. The churchman was skeptical and dismissed a humble peasant, who then returned to Tepeyac Hill to beseech the Virgin Mary to find a more prominent person who was less pitiably poor than he to do her bidding. Rejecting his protestations, the Virgin urged him to return to the bishop, and indeed say to him once more how it is I myself, the ever-Virgin Saint Mary, Mother of God, who am commissioning you. Juan Diego returned to the churchman's palace after Mass, waited, and was finally able to enter his second plea on behalf of the Virgin. This time, Zumarraga asked the humble native to request a sure sign directly from the heavenly woman as to her true identity. The bishop then had some members of his staff follow Juan Diego to check on where he went and whom he saw. The next day, Juan Diego hastened to the bedside of his dying uncle, Juan Bernardino. The old man, gravely ill, begged his nephew to fetch a priest for the last rites of the church. The following morning before dawn, Juan Diego set off on this mission. He tried to avoid the Virgin because of his uncle's worsening condition, but she intercepted him and asked, "Where are you going?" He confessed that it was on behalf of his uncle that he was rushing to summon a priest. During this third meeting, she assured him that the uncle was healed up, as she has already made a separate appearance to him. She also comforted Juan Diego with the assurance that she would give him sure proof of her real identity. On December 12th, 1531, the Virgin appeared to Juan Diego for the fourth time and bade him to go to the top of Tepeyac Hill and pick Castilian garden flowers from the normally barren summit. She helped him by taking them up in her own hands and folded them into his cloak, woven of maguey plant fibers. Juan Diego then set off to Zumarraga's palace with this sure sign of the Virgin Mary of Guadalupe's identity. As he unwrapped his cloak, the flowers tumbled at the churchman's feet, and suddenly, upon the cloak, there flashed a portrait where sallied into view, a sacred image of that ever-Virgin Holy Mary, Mother of God.